What is up, guys, and welcome to the Beyond Sanity channel. My name is Shinx, and today, once again, on the epic map Anorian, we are going to play a 2v2 match in Battle for Middle Earth 1 on the patch 2.22. Everybody is picking random, and we get to play Isengard Mordor combination, who now has the strength to face against the forces of Isengard and Mordor. Nobody. Or maybe the connections. So basically, we need to also guide our ally a little bit because he has not enough experience. So he gotta start with an orc bit and build the troll cage after. Okay, now he knows what's up, and that's very important. And I am guiding him now, I'm carrying him now, but that's an investment into the future. Hopefully in the future, he will get the chance to carry me. And I personally, when I play Isengard in a 2v2 match on the map Anorian, I like to build up two furnaces at the beginning of the game, because in the worst case scenario, which would mean we are losing both the settlements outside, we should have still a great amount of resource income to recover from it. And now we got a wall check. It's a good faction topside and evil faction at the bottom side. I am choosing to defend actually in this matchup because I have nothing coming up anytime soon, and I would love to keep my Lumber Mills protected. With the War Chant, we should be able to fight this, no problemo. And hopefully my ally is going to win the Mordor Mirror match. Okay, so the plan is simple. We will gonna be the carry faction in this situation, and Mordor, our ally, is going to hopefully provide us a lot of... Oh, never mind, he's using I already. And Mordor, our ally, is gonna hopefully be able to provide us with additional damage and armor leadership. I mean, actually, who's gonna win this? He used heal, and he has also the Eye of Sauron from his own teammate. It might be a close fight, but I'm fine with it. Even if I lose this fight, it doesn't really matter too much, because I am able to keep them away from my settlement. That's all that matters, right? And we have now three furnaces in total. We're gonna build one more, and we should be in a very good spot. I would love to rush Lourdes eventually, but, you know, I believe Lourdes is not even that important in this matchup. Why are you asking? Glad you're asking, because Lourdes' leadership is actually not even required. We will have War Chant, Eye of Sauron, Drummer Troll, Darkness, Witch King. So we are not lacking in the PowerPoints department. We are actually lacking in the units department. And I would love to now recruit a crossbowman first. This way I can defend myself against the soldiers. And I actually was feeding him a little bit. He has now a level 2 soldier battalion. That's going to be kind of painful. But it's okay. We have crossbowmen coming up very, very soon. And we should be in a good spot. And luckily for us, once again, we were able to get, like, in total 4 furnaces now inside the castle. Which means we have shot... We should have a great amount... Oh, he's not paying attention. Yeah, chase me, baby, one more time. Oh, dude, this guy is not paying attention. He's losing the full battalion to the tower. Okay, I take you. Thank you very much, soldier. Thank you very much. Okay, and there are two specific reasons why we are recruiting crossbowmen, by the way. The one reason is it's going to be a bit more helpful to defend ourselves, because we can keep shooting and disengaging when we have to. And the second reason is because crossbowmen is giving us double the XP from an Uruk high. It means our Uruk pit, this way, will be able to level up to level 2 much, much sooner, which is required for us to get the chance to recruit the Uruk pikemen. I mean, this matchup should be actually favoring the Gondor Mordor team, because the combination of good and evil is always, almost every single time, greater than any other combination in the game, because the Gondor can pressure us all the time with the Gondor Knights, and Mordor will have an infinite time to skill, to support the Gondor with a Nazgul with the Witch King, and break through our defense, which are gonna be either pikemen or the mountain trolls. And we need to eventually be defending pretty much until we get the freezing rain from the spellbook. But we are creeping. However, our crossbowman Uruk combination doesn't deal too much damage, unfortunately. We need one more Urukai to get the Uruk pit to level 2. And then we will be able, ladies and gentlemen, to recruit the Uruk pikeman. And our eco is looking pretty good. Oh, this hobbit is actually annoying me. Hobbit, die. Die now. This peregrine took is so tanky. I'm gonna war chance here. Now you gotta run, my friend. Now we need to creep this. Okay. Crossbows. My ally is also not doing too bad. We need to use one of the crossbowmen to defend. I don't want to lose any of these settlements yet. And our Urukbit is now level 2. That's good. Now we can recruit some pikemen and keep this way our settlements also protected against the Gondonites. However, pikemen only are not going to be enough because pikemen are extremely weak and vulnerable against orcs. And for that reason, we need to eventually recruit some berserkers to deal with the pikemen spam. So, we are defending, that's pretty good. They have also still a great amount of money, and for that reason I would love to build the armory very, very soon. Hopefully after creeping this we will get additional resources, which is going to be quite helpful. I mean, the problem is our crossbowmen are actually dealing almost no damage to the lair itself. That's why we... Oh, here's the hobbit there. I want to kill this hobbit actually. Come on, can I do it? Please, 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 please. Oh, he got the last... Okay, FF, surrender, guys. Surrender. Surrender! He's Oros! He's cheating! And he got the Hobbit cloak. I'm about to lose my freaking mind. No! No, why would you do that? Full of a talk, Gandalf was right about you. Throw yourself in there, you know what I'm saying, next time. So we are safe from your stupidity. I mean, I was actually thinking that Gandalf was a little bit too harsh on Peregrine Took. But after this move, I 100% agree with Gandalf. Hopefully, and I kind of said that he didn't throw Pippin inside this, you know what I'm saying, in Moria. Alright, so we need to try to creep this. That's going to be kind of painful, because without leadership and also fire arrows, the crossbowman Uruk... Oh, combination, please! Okay, surrender this game. Dude, I'm done, I'm done. Get me out of this game, please. Dude, that's my problem, by the way, guys. If something bad happens to me in the video game, I keep throwing even harder. You know what I'm saying? I will keep throwing this all the time. You will hate to see that. Oh my god, look at this troll. He doesn't want to die. And now we have to go... Dude, we are so doomed. He's trampling us down too. Holy moly. Hey, 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 Gondonites. Okay, he's paying attention too. Okay, at least we were able to save both the battalions so we can buy banner on them and we should be in a good spot. And what is my lords doing? Lords, come on now. Actually, oh, okay. Please kill this Gondonites. Now he's gonna get away. He's using the Elven Wood, which is okay for me because I want to go for the industry. And then, can we get the money at least, please? Let's use industry first of all on these 3 furnaces. And we get 1 part of the money, I believe. That's okay. But still not worth it, you know? We lost both the creeps to this Gondo player. Oh, you are on my list, bro. You are on my list. I'm coming for you. And look at this orc spam. It's quite annoying too, right? Because we need to be careful to not feed our pikemen to these orcs. And don't underestimate orcs. So we have lords, we have armory. And before purchasing any upgrades on our units, we need to make sure to purchase all the upgrades from the armory and demolish the armory as soon as we can to get one more additional slot spot for one more additional furnace.
You'll do what I say.
More laborers, eh? Put them to work.
I mean, you know, eventually I don't know what my ally is doing at this point, but again, we are the carry faction in a situation. Mordor can only support us, and for that reason we need to be the one who is recruiting a lot of army. And in this game, I will show you guys how to manage big-sized armies, okay? Because at some point of the game, I am planning to have like 5, 6, 8 combat battalions at the same time. Which might be required because you cannot only push. You need to always keep something inside your own castle, but also inside the castle of your ally. You know, because if you leave your castle, it will be open for a potential attack and rush from the Gondonites. With Eye of Sauron, with Witch King, they might be able to deal devastating amount of damage, and we need to be kind of prepared for that. So leaving one pikeman is not gonna be enough, because the Witch King or a Nazgul can one-shot the pikeman. That's why we will need to leave one pikeman and at bare minimum one combo. But luckily for us, the thing is that Gondor usually gives one farm to his ally. So basically Mordor opening from us has 3 settlements, and this Gondor has only one single farm, which means he has not a great eco. And you can see, oh, 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 hey, Gondonites, Gondonites. Oh yes, that feels so good. There we go, there we go. Hey, that's the payment, man. Payment. Karma is everywhere, even in Battle for Middle-earth 1. And that's the payment, because you stole my creep, you stole my money. And now I stole the life of one of your Gondonite battalion. Oh! Okay, that's gonna actually slow down even Gondor more and more and more. Once again, Gondor has not the greatest amount of resource income. He has not any of the highly leveled Gondonites. And every second, every minute, is going to get our furnaces also tankier. So I see a Nazgul. We need to be prepared as soon as possible. I mean, the Mordor from the opening is quite rich, right? And I'm surprised that he didn't capture the middle camp. Normally, when I would play Mordor and my ally is Gondor, and I'm against a Mordor and Isengard combination, I personally would definitely purchase the middle camp and build multiple orc pits to keep spamming orcs all day, all night. Okay, so we are getting stronger. They are giving us actually a lot of time, which is good for us. Our Lord is only level, almost level 2, but it's fine, because with the insane amount of combat experience leadership we will get later on from the Drummer Throne and from Dire of Sauron, also our heroes are gonna be able to level up quite fast, and our Lord should have no problem whatsoever to reach to level 5. So, okay, so my ally hopefully will also recruit the Witch King for me, because Witch King and Drummer, and we are good to go. And who, guys, likes the... Oh, the Witch King is coming. Okay, we gotta go now. We gotta go. We need to save our ally. Let's use the industry for the second time. We need eventually some more towers, but we are kind of broke. And these Gondonites, though, they have so much leadership now. They have 100% more damage as we are talking. And they are also leveling up like crazy. Witch King, maybe we can burst him down. We can also use Cripple on the Witch King, by the way. It doesn't stop him. Oh, we missed the Cripple. Cripple is one of these abilities in Battle for Middle-Earth 1 that has like a limited range. And if the target is out of the range, it will go on cooldown, but it won't hit anything. And you cannot only cripple down enemy heroes, but also you can damage anything you hit, including buildings with the cripple. And the flying heroes like the Eagles or the Nazgûls or the Witch King cannot be crippled down, but the cripple from Lourdes still deals insane amount of damage to those heroes. And my ally is making, for whatever reason, orc arches. That's definitely not required. That's a waste of money, because I am the one who is making combos in this situation. Okay, so he's coming. But we have a lot of towers. So as you can see, they are putting pressure and using the mobility advantage they got over us. That's why I was saying before, we need like 3-4 armies. This way, we are not going to be prisoned. And we are finally allowed to leave our castle. And as you also can see, I don't like to make those combos with pikemen and crossbowmen. I want to actually... I'm gonna use warchant here. Should be able to fight this. Oh, he's using... Okay. Okay, my ally is covering, but they have double land, so we gotta move now. Luckily, my ally's trolls are coming in clutch. And the Witch King can't really approach. We have 3 combos on the field. And Lourdes is level 3 now. That's pretty dope. We need 2 more levels for even greater amount of damage output. And that's what I'm talking about, you know, when you want to leave your castle, you want to keep something in your castle too. Oh my goodness, man, this guy is pressuring us with orcs, and that's so annoying in long terms. And the thing is, you need to always be aware, be paying attention, you know, always. Okay, so I wish I had enough money for the middle camp, but unfortunately, that's only a dream. Now I want to move. I want to deal actually some damage to Mordor if we can. I don't know how many units and how many trolls he got on the field. Hopefully not too many. We need to wait for the Drummer Troll to come, because my ally has still not the Troll Cage level 2. And once again, he's missed the... He was going for the Fire Arrows too on this Orc Arches. That's a waste of money. Trust me on that one. You don't want to do that. You want to actually save up for the Witch King. You want to get Drummer Troll, 2 of them, and then save up for the Witch King only. That's your goal as Mordor if you are playing with Isengard as ally. Okay, now he has Witch King, he has Gondonites with full upgrades. I'm a little bit scared, to be honest with you. I'm a little bit scared, because that's our entire army, pretty much. If we lose that, the counterattack from them might be strong enough to defeat us with one single push. So we need to kind of sit here and wait for the Drummer Troll to come. As we are talking, we have 0 leadership. Our War Chain is even on cooldown. It means taking a fight would be definitely not a wise choice. But now we have also 1 combo inside our ally's castle. That's pretty dope. Just making sure, because the furnaces are a bit tankier than slaughterhouses, so my ally's castle is a bit more vulnerable. Okay, the Gondor might go for a rush, which is gonna be good for us because I believe he's underestimating our defense. Okay, so Warchant in about 3 seconds. And the, oh, what is he doing with the Gondor Knights? Okay, you know what? I would love to get 3 power points. Even though, oh, he has catapults too. Oh, wait, that's painful. That's painful. That's really painful. Okay, that's... okay, let me think. Let me think what we are supposed to do here. Okay, hopefully we have enough DPS to one-shot those catapults. And hopefully we are also tanky enough to not get one-shotted by these catapults once again. I want to kill them only. He has 2 already off on the field. We need to keep moving, keep moving. Oh, the he's using the land. Oh, I don't have land yet. I'm diving too deep, though. I don't know about that. Kill the catapults, please. So we gotta move out from the land because on the land we have no leadership. The Dramatrol is coming. The Gondor Knights are coming too. The pikemen, they need to get in position. Please, 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 please. My ally has some trolls. Dramatrol isn't supposed to attack. When Dramatrol attacks, we lose the leadership bonuses. He needs to be drumming all the time to give leadership, if you don't know. Okay, I mean, we lose everything here, by the way. We lose literally everything. We killed some catapults, but he had too many. Like, he had like 4 or 5 catapults. And a smart move from the enemy Mordor player to use the land to make sure we are losing all the leadership bonuses. But we at least killed the trolls. Can we actually finish off this Witch King, please? The cripple is on cooldown. We need now more reinforcement to join the battlefield as soon as possible. Okay, okay, the Witch King was able to get away, but maybe we can save those combos, and every single one of them is level 2, so if we can send them back all the way back to the castle, we can just let them recover over time. And Gondor, in the meantime, was focusing on the map control. We lost one of the settlements, which is okay, but for the next fight, we have also our own Tainted Land, which we're not gonna use until Mordor is gonna use it, or Gondor is gonna use it, you know? So the breaking point is actually not us getting lords level 5. No, we want to get lords to level 6. And now you might be asking, but why Shanks? Because of pillage. And we will kill so many orcs, so many Gondor Knights in this game, that we also need this additional resource income, guys. Because as you can see, we are investing the money non-stop, right? We have almost no money at all, because we keep making more units. But this way, you can also even extend your command point. So basically, you can have more units on the field than you are allowed to. Because the command points are calculated based on every single unit and not per battalion. What is my pikeman doing here? Okay, so go back, please. He was following the Gondor Knights all the way back to their home. Okay, so we have one combo here. That's good. Now we need to, you know, send those combos which are damaged back to the castle to recover. And the ones which are quite healthy, we can group them all up and go for one more attack. We need to be fast though, because Mordor will keep spamming more and more catapults, get additional Nazguls on the field, maybe even trolls. And because we picked the Tainted Land, we are still 6 power points away from the Freezing Rain. It means the enemy trolls with Witch King and Eye and Darkness will be definitely tough to deal with. So I really wish my ally would have also Witch King on the field, but I believe he has definitely not the eco. And once again, the investment into the Fire Arrows and Orc Archers was definitely a bad call. But it's okay, he didn't play too many 2v2 games yet, and that's what we are, you know, here for, right? We want to teach him, so he can also basically, hopefully, in the future, be able to carry me. So I'm always happy to see new faces, new players in our community, which is a pretty solid and small... But it's lovely, you know what I'm saying? Size doesn't matter everything. That's what she said. Okay, so I wish we had also enough money to recruit the White Wizard. Unfortunately, that's only a dream. We have not the money as we are talking, but who knows? Who knows? Maybe soon. As you can see, we are not allowed to recruit any more units. We have 435, even though we are actually allowed to have only 400. And we will have even more because more and more combos are recovering as we are to look at this. 445 now. We have 10% more. And we are, oh, there is Gandalf, Mithrandir, okay. I mean, good luck with, Gandalf is a, you know, amazing hero. My favorite hero by far in all Battle for Middle-earth games. But we have too much leadership on the table. For that reason, he won't be able to achieve too much. So our Mordor has, I mean, the opponent Mordor has 1 Nazgul. Hold on a second. Gandalf, you want to really do this? Our opponent Mordor has also 1 Nazgul and the Witch King. but we have so much leadership. we can one tap them, right? We can one tap them and they're gonna be gone in a second. I mean, I wish I could go here for the siege weapons, but as you can see and tell, we have zero available command points. Now, obviously, I could sell my combos, but that's definitely not on the to-do list. I don't want to waste my units, which were extremely hard for me to afford and also expensive. I would rather lose them, not all of them, you know, a couple of the units from the battalion and send them again. And this way, I can eventually even have more than 500 command points at the same time on the field. That's the plan. So what is this Nazgul doing? If Nazgul is not paying attention, rest in peace, my friend. Oh, okay, Nazgul is... get one-shotted. No. Okay, our combos, they needed to shoot. I'm gonna use industry also on my allies piece. So he has now 6 Lord Houses with industry. Because we have really not money to spend elsewhere, really. I mean, we can save up for the Saruman, that's all about it. But I want my ally to recruit Witch King. That's the reason why we are using industry on... Oh... He has combos, trolls, drummer troll, witch king, Nazguls, and also catapults. You wanna fight? You wanna play rough? Let's go! Nazgul down, ladies and gentlemen. Level 4 lords, that's massive. We need only one more level, and then we are golden. So I have two combos inside my allies' castle for the worst case scenario. Always hope for the best, but... be prepared for the worst. That should be your, you know, game logic, because everything might fall into darkness and then you have always like a plan B, like a backup plan, you know? Okay, let's go. I mean, here's like so many catapults, and even Gondor is now recruiting some archers. I want to cripple this Gandalf, but he won't give me the chance to do that. Look, our command points are dropping, and also the opponent was using the darkness, by the way. What is Gandalf doing? Gandalf, you want to do this? Hey, Gandalf! What are you doing? What, did I miss my cripple? No, my cripple didn't go off for whatever reason. But the Witch King from him? The Witch King and Lords is level 5. Now we are talking. Gandalf is coming, Gandalf is coming, Gandalf is coming. Cripple him. Cripple him, Lords. Please. Now we can turn and kill him. Kill him, kill him now. Kill, kill, kill. Alright, he cannot move. He's crippled. Okay, the Witch King has to be careful. We gotta use the Tainted Land to cover this. Oh, he is heal on Gandalf, but that will only make him survive 5 more seconds. The opponent Gondor used the Elven Wood, but my ally has his own Tainted Land to cover this. And once again, dude, we are losing so many command points, and mainly and exclusively from these catapults. They are so painful. However, we have the middle camp with full furnaces. We have actually a great amount of resource income, and hopefully we will be able to save one of these combos too. So we can now bring the reinforcements, and we have 4 more... Oh my lord, I didn't pay attention, my bad. Gotta kill this troll though. The trolls are smashing. We are only 1 power point away from the freezing rain. And that's the reason, you see? It's so important that we have now some backup. Because we lost everything. We killed Gandalf and Witch King and Nazgul, true. But also, we lost everything in exchange. Now, if we wouldn't have an army, Mordor, Gondor would get the chance to push us back all the way to our castle. But they can't now, because we are getting more and more units on the field. Where is the Witch King, though, from my ally? Did he lose the Witch King? I'm not sure. I mean, I also need a drummer troll. Please kill it. I gotta use fortunes. Oh, the troll is coming. Let's kill the troll first. More combos. Okay, we have freezing rain now. Oh, not feel the fires. Dude, I almost misclicked. Alright. I see. Okay, what? It didn't go off. I'm gonna use freezing rain here. Oh, my combos are taking so much damage. In the meantime, I'm losing the middle camp. Where is my reinforcement? Where is my ally? I need some... not orcs. Don't send me orcs. Send me trolls, drummer trolls, something. Okay, okay. I mean, this Rohirrim special summon from Gondor is actually messing me up. I was hoping that we have enough leadership that I don't need any more pikemen. But unfortunately, during this fight, we had zero leadership. Our drummer troll was not around. But the Isengard combos are still beefy. So I don't want to lose the middle camp though. We need to recruit more and more units. And what is happening? Is he disconnecting actually? Please not. Please not. Okay. Okay. He's back. So I want to get also Saruman on the field. Remember the golden time in which we had like 450 out of 400 command points available? Hey. This is not this day anymore. We lost a lot. Okay, so luckily we were able to save the middle camp. That's good. That's like the center of this map, Anorian. And if we lose the control of the smith site, it might be doomed. So we can now use industry on every single furnace in the middle, because we need to now recruit more and more units. A new power is rising and victory is at hand. As you see, Saruman the Great joining the battlefield. Lourdes is almost back on the menu as well. That's good. We need now some more combos ASAP upon the field. We have Saruman leadership and Lourdes leadership as well. That's dope. And we know Gandalf is still dead. So he might be back very soon on the field. But if even if he comes, you could see yourself in the last situation. Gandalf is not really able to play the game. If you pay attention as Isengard, you have the best hero in the game. The most cost-efficient hero in the game by far is Lourdes. 1400 gives you pillage, gives you carnage, gives you leadership, gives you the chance to fight with bow and sword. And then on top of that, you are an anti-hero. So basically, there is an enemy hero which causes problems. Hey, guess what? Not anymore, because you have Lourdes and you cripple them down with level 1. My ally is going for siege works, that's good. I mean, it's fine for me if they are actually not attacking us, because we can just wait for the freezing rain to be back up once again. And with the freezing rain, we should be able to overpower the enemy army. So we have 4 combos inside the allies' castle, and we have also 2 combos inside our own castle. So we have in total 7 combos as we are talking. 7 combos, 8 combos now. I mean, that's the army Saruman wanted from Sauron wanted from Saruman. He said, build me an army worthy of Mordor and death. Ladies and gentlemen, is the plan. We did it. We definitely did it. Okay, so we are in a very good spot. Very, very good spot. Our money is still not looking good because we keep investing stuff, but it's fine. We don't need money. We need army, you know? Okay, so Mordor is moving. Our freezing rain is unfortunately still on cooldown, but we might make something happen. So what I want to do is I want to fireball one of these catapults. I want to get... Because the catapults are the biggest threat to our army. I mean, there is no army... I mean, no orc archer combo competition can actually match with our strength. Because Mordor has only Drummer, Troll, Witch King, but we have this, Warchant, Eye, and Lourdes. So we are definitely... And also Isengard combos are obviously much stronger because they have heavy armor and orc archers, they don't. You know, if I'm not mistaken, this has to be our land. If I'm not mistaken. But I'm mistaken because the enemy units wouldn't glow. Okay, please back. Nice. Can't touch this. Oh, Witch King, I don't know about that. Don't do that. Okay. I need some Drummer Trolls now from my ally around this side. Let's go. We gotta kill some catapults. But I don't want to go on the enemy land. That's my problem. Okay, one of the catapults is down. I see darkness. We have also Eye of Sauron. Saruman is coming. The Drummer Troll is coming. We should be extremely tanky. Level 6, which means now money. You can see we are collecting treasures and money as we are talking. And maybe we can steal the combos if Mordor is not paying attention. Mordor is paying attention, actually. Let's back off with Saruman. The trolls are diving in. 112 for killing one of these trolls. But once again, also these rangers with this much leadership are hitting like a truck. And we cannot step on this tainted land. We cannot. I mean, we can, which would be a suicide squad. And we would lose literally everything within a few seconds. And all these rangers would be hitting level 10. So I want them to come out and fight me. I want to cripple this Gandalf. Okay, he got crippled. Oh, he didn't get crippled. Cripple him, dude. Okay, he got crippled now. We are losing the Saruman, unfortunately. Please kill Gandalf already, man. Why is this guy so tanky? Okay, he got killed. I don't know what is happening. We see 20 Nazgûl flying around. Wizards falling. Saruman in right after Gandalf. Who is who? Who is who? Okay, this is our Witch King, all right? And this is also our Nazgûl, right? Okay, this is the enemy Nazgûl. So we can kill him. We need more army at the very same time. Freezing Rain is available. That's our Witch King, okay? But these are the enemy Rangers, obviously. And we have also more reinforcement. And that's the beautiful strategy what we are doing as we are talking, right? We are always able to lose army, but we have so much sustain in our army that we can always replace them to keep the pressure 24/7. Okay, now we gotta build a little bit because we are taking too much damage. Now I want to also build up a siege works, boys. I want to build a siege works, and as we are putting pressure on Mordor, I'm also planning to put pressure on Gondor, because I believe their tunnel vision focus on the one big fight, and maybe we can keep their attention to the Mordor castle, and they won't be paying attention to the Gondor castle. So Faramir, run. It's not your day to show your quality, brother. Alright, 10 power points almost collected. The good thing about Isengard and also about the EO factions like Mordor is, if as you are losing units, you also gain power points, right? And that's the main reason why Balrog Summon for the evil factions costs you 20 power points, and Army of the Dead Special Summon for the good factions costs you only 10. So let's recruit some Rams. Again, that's gonna be like a sneaky attack, like a Trojan horse, you know, the film Troy. Oh, the Witch King. Is this the Witch King? It's a Nazgul, but he has two Nazguls. Keep the Drummer Troll to me. Let's use... I wanna use... Oh man, he has so many catapults though. Oh! Let's use War Chant here. Gotta burst down those Nazguls. That's, oh, but we are getting knocked down on the ground. We should have waited for the other army before we approach. I don't know about that. Dude, okay. I mean, our army is getting literally crushed. And these catapults are hitting like a truck. Please kill these. Hey, the Witch King. Is it his Witch King? No, that's our Witch King. But too many summons. You know, Rohirrim summon. Yeah, my ally is doing a good job. Just sacrifice one of your Nazguls if necessary. All you gotta do is kill those catapults. That's all I'm expecting from you. Even if you lose a Nazgul, that doesn't really matter. The only hero you need to keep alive is the Witch King. And Nazguls can be sacrificed for killing important stuff. Like a siege works, for example, or like catapults, trebuchet, and stuff like that. Okay, now we can keep up the pressure, even though we got badly damaged. I don't know about that. Luckily, we are getting... Look, our money, though. We are so rich now. The middle camp, pillage from lords, industry over and over again. Multiple level 3 furnaces. I mean, money is not a problem. But we keep also investing money all the time. And look at this. This one ram might actually create so much pressure. And those ranges, they are also dying like flies. They cannot, you know, the problem is, even though I'm upset about seeing catapults, but in reality, there is not much else they can do. They cannot match the army in strength, because one button, that's the freezing rain, can shut down the entire existence of the leadership system of the enemy factions. So basically, they need trebuchet, they need catapults if they want to be able to kill our army. That's the problem. Let's level them up, and we need 5 more power points, boys, for the demon of the ancient world. Freezing rain, enough darkness, let's get rid of darkness. 15 power points collected, we are getting more and more power points collected. And we need to just make sure to kill the siege warriors. This way, the enemy isn't able to recruit any more siege weapons anytime soon. War Chant is on cooldown. Gondor Knights, they can't really do much. They have not enough leadership. I mean, Battle for Middle-earth 1, love it or hate it, is a leadership-based army. Hold on a second. Can I steal them? Did I really miss them? How did I miss them? Boom, be gone. On your face, son. Alright, the Nazguls are knocking us down all the time. I don't know what is going on. Too many flying heroes around. Let me tell you that much. 9 power points in the bank. You know, Gandalf is dead, if I'm not mistaken. And we have 17 power points, right? 3 more. Oh, here's Gandalf. Oh, my ram wasn't doing anything. He was just chilling. I want to kill this Witch King, please. Can I fireball him? Take this, Witch King. Phew! Actually, chunks a lot. Look at this wombo combo. Cripple plus fireball. Okay, enemy is using Elven Wood. We don't need to cover this, right? We can just peel back. And we have also, again, another army. So they think they did deal with our army. But little they know... Because we have a backup, dude. Like, all you can eat. You know what I'm saying? Like, there comes another big army. Oh, my level 5 combo. Ah, it's okay. I mean, he's also level 10 Gondor Knight. Don't underestimate him. Can I actually cover both of these at the same time? Let's not right-click. I don't want to right-click on any ability. I would not recommend you to right-click on any ability too. Because right-clicking makes your heroes do weird things. And... these weird things are barely anytime good, so it's not a good thing to use this, trust me that one. I want to build the armory once again, because we didn't purchase the forge plates, so I am pretty tempted to buy the forge plates and eventually recruit, hold on a second, eventually recruit some war riders, you know? Why? Because I want to kill those catapults. They are annoying me. Okay, let's go. Okay, so Gondor is coming. Where was Gondor when Mordor fell? But I don't think this Gondor can approach us. Okay, we one-shot the catapult with the fireball. That's great. This Gandalf can... Oh! Gandalf cannot play the game, dude. Gandalf cannot play the game. Lord is so awesome, man. I always keep falling in love with the fighting Uruk-hai. So incredibly powerful. Look at this burst. I mean, what can Gandalf do against such a... Look at these Nazgûs. They are like flies, like pew, 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 left and right. Just kill the catapult, and guess what? I'm gonna summon the blue eyes. White... No, it's not the real game. It's not the right game. Let's summon the Balrog to destroy the Gondor, the White City. The Eagles are coming. The Eagles can come all they want, Peregrine took. They don't stand a chance. My Saruman might be in trouble, but it's okay. I mean... I don't think they can deal with this Balrog anymore. I don't know if they have AOT. I don't think so. This Gondor didn't kill too much. And now, little demonstration of the mightiest creature in battle for Middle-earth 1. And they have also Remy. Rams, we are ramming him at the same time. So Breathfire got nerfed this patch, the patch 2.22. It's not longer able to one-shot production buildings. You can see the farms are going down, but the archer range and stable, they don't go down because they are level 3. But it's okay, we have Rams to back them up anyway. So Rams, look at the Rams, they can keep killing those, you know, like this blacksmiths, no problemo. Backflip flying. We are also defeating Mordor at the same time. I think this game is over, even if Mordor somehow gets the Balrog summon unlocked, which might be a possible thing because he kills a lot with his catapults. I don't think he would be able to defeat one of us. I mean, he cannot defeat me because we have a middle camp and a castle. And even if he defeats an ally of us, he cannot fight in a one-on-one situation anymore. Yoda has been defeated. And Mordor is about to lose as well. And if you guys enjoy this kind of videos, please make sure to leave a like. Subscribe for more content like this in the future. And let me know in the comment section down below, what would you like to see the most in the upcoming game? I mean, I play really what I get. And I always pick random. But if you want me to play a specific faction, you can also let me know in the comment section down below. I will try my best to get it done for you guys. And thank you so much for the huge support, by the way. Thanks for watching the videos, guys. Really means a lot to me. You guys are awesome. I really hope to see you also in one of the live streams in the upcoming days. Until then, yeah, the victorious as always. Because I know you guys want to see me lose, but I don't lose. What can I do? I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck. And also, stay beyond standards. Peace out, guys.